Hey, you don't hear?
Well, about another project today. Got the fan over there close to the camera, but that'll be so far. Bunch door springs broke. Both ends. I had a hook on this end, and it just fell off when this one broke. These are the kind that stretch. They're called expansion springs. This is what broke off. It's just a coil of the spring on the end there. And this was the hook that was on that coil. And I'm going to hook probably this on one end because it's big. And then I lost the other. There was another one and I lost it somehow. I usually don't do that. These are off of bungee cords. And I think they'll be big enough. They're bigger around than the spring was. They're just, actually, they're pretty stiff because I tried to bend one a while ago. So sanding disc on my drill there. I'm gonna try to clean these sharp edges up so I don't get hurt working with these things. Just sharp enough. There's a spot. Oh, just sharp enough to really cut. Waste a lot of time taking gloves on and off. I should just put them on. Okay, now. Get the grill out of the way for now. Let's see. I'll show you where it goes. So here it is. I don't know how good I was showing it, but there it is up close. It's kind of bent. I think I might have had that hook right up in there. I kind of think I remember. I thought it needed to be pulling harder on that side because the spring was stretched the last time I put a hook on it, but don't know for sure. All I know is, okay, let's see. Go up the ladder. Oh! Okay, now here's one that's hooked up and working, if I can show it. See, there's the other hook that I put in there. That's one I put, that was just this one wire goes down the middle of the spring, and that's the original how it's supposed to be, and there's that eye bolt there. And so it was actually hooked right here, and keep not paying attention where my camera is, and it was about almost ripped through. It was just barely hanging, so I put a hook on it and went around a little further so it'd be just tight enough. Of course, it's loose now because it'll be tighter, I think, when it's down and the springs are stretched. But you can see down through there, there's a pulley that goes on the other end and a cable. All that's okay. None of it got damaged. And this one is just nothing there right now. Light makes it look funky, doesn't it? It'll be too dark for me to see in there without it, without it on. But, so that's what I'm going to do. Let me get down again. I think I'll put this up here now. Maybe. And, let's see. Try to aim it to work and see what's going on, but not set up my little workbench out of my door on the, there we go. I think that's where I'm going to be working. Okay, so what I'm thinking is there's a couple of different things I've been thinking about how to do it. Yeah, it'd be better if I was pointing towards the camera, wouldn't it? Anyway, don't have a lot of good places to put stuff. Just hook it through there. I'm not even going to, as stiff as these springs are, I'm not going to even try to straighten that out. But I've got to get them out. I've got some U-bolts. And what I'm thinking of doing is hooking, so like you could almost spread them out and hook it through there, like on about two or three of them. Three of them, probably. To keep it from, over time, if this spring was to spin, since there's both ends are going to be hooked now, it was to spin. That was so fat, I may have to be able to get it through there. I may have to use, and yeah, I think I may use the, I want to use the bigger one on that end. I don't know. No. Yeah, it'd be easier to hook and unhook with the bigger end. So, whatever ones I decide to use. I was thinking about clamping some U-bolts on there. I think I'll just get them in there first and then decide about that. I got some U-bolts that just might do the trick when it comes to getting them in there. Just leave them laying there so that they can keep this thing from rolling away. Let's see. I think three. Yeah, these are a lot longer. I think they'll give me a better, even though that's tougher, I think these are tough enough. And I think they'll give me a better, and I think I'm going to go in three or two. Two's plenty. I know it's not going to break. I mean, well, what's that? Maybe one. What's that? Okay. Now I don't trust it just like that, and I think I'll bring it on around to the work it on around to where that hook is, or where that hook used to be. Now I don't think that's gonna actually, doesn't matter to me. I had actually thought about, oops, you could do that. Weld it right there. I got a welder. Could just weld it right there and then hit it like here. That's, I kept having that idea in my head about welding. I thought, well, is that really necessary? Maybe it's a bit, I don't want to overheat the spring and make it weak where it'll break by getting it too hot, but if you just hit it a little bit, that would work better than those U-bolts. Easier to get on there than those U-bolts, I think. Let's do that twice here. I thought this would, might end up really fighting me, but it's not as bad as I had thought it could be. squeeze it around a little further. No, not really. Where's this other one? Oh, okay. Yeah, a little further. Why does it match up so good? Oh, I see. So it's actually just about in the right place. Yeah. Oops, too far. I know, that's not a hammer, but it hits the right spot. There. Only thing is, if you weld them, maybe they're not going in the right direction. Although that looks like it'd be perfect. But they're more flexible like that, and I don't want to try to weld it up there because I've got that whole side of the garage stacked with boxes and paint and gasoline cans down there, and I'd have to move every bit of that. So I don't want to try to weld it like that. So. That makes it line right up. Yeah. If I'm gonna weld it, I gotta do it now. Before I get a U-bolt out and see what that's gonna look like first before I decide to go dragging the welder out. Everything is a drink. I'll show you what I mean. Okay, let me back up. Okay, there's all the paint, and I actually cleaned that out. I had all kinds of brand new wood stacked up there, 4x8 sheets of 1/4 inch plywood and stuff. Moved it so I could get up in there better, and because I wanted it away from the end down here where the weather was getting to it. It's all, can't see it from here. See, all that whole side of the garage is full of boxes and stuff, so no welding. That's a no welding zone up there. But I have my welder is back here. It's on rollers. If that thing, well, that took that. I'm running into stuff. I need a big shop, big old shop. But no, I don't want to get it right in my junk. It's projects that I want to work on one day. Yeah, at least I would like to. Okay, water. Hang on now. Down there is where my U-boats are. And that's the, if you didn't see it before, that's the part that broke off the ring. There they are. U-boats! So let's see. Yeah, see, I got stuff in there. Got a neat little, I used to carry that around in my truck sometimes. That's a pretty handy little toolbox. Okay, so put that back like it was. Now, while I'm thinking about the U-bolts, got other stuff in here too. If your wagon wheels come off, you can buy these little knock-on caps and put them back on. Got a wagon. I have a small air compressor and a little tank. It's actually one of those portable air tanks that you can carry around. And that's the only tank it has. So I keep it like that. Keep it in the wagon and I can drag it around. So I have several different kinds. So these are the ones I was thinking of. Here's a bigger one. And a smaller one. Let's get around and run. Know what I'm showing. Bigger one. Smaller one. They're brand new. That's still got plastic on it. Hadn't been ripped off yet. Let's see. Looks like I robbed the nuts off of some of them. At some point I got desperate for these little nuts. These are 1/4 20s, I think. That's what it was. I got desperate for 1/4 20s. But these tools. I got too much junk on my work. But this is my table saw, that bench table that I built. And I got junk on it. And I cleaned out my room. See, that one doesn't want to go through there because of its diameter. And it doesn't have nuts on it anyway. Let's try one of these. I mean, I don't see any reason why these wouldn't stay. Once I got them, if I can get them in there. All right. Let's see. And they would actually be adjustable. Oh, you know what? I don't think there's really any way to get a hold of it. This one is too narrow. Since I grabbed two, unless I put it,
I don't think that would hold, be worth anything. You could put it on here like this. That wouldn't really be holding anything. I want it to go through and over. Is it too dark to see? I want it to go through and over. And this one, well, I guess it would just make it. I'd want it. I guess the nuts on the inside would be all right. I have to spread it out some more to get it on. It's not going to go around that and that. So those are too little. These are for tightening up guy wires and stuff, really. Cables. U-clamps, something. I have some interesting ones. Back in 2009, I had a job installing wiring and DSO equipment in telephone company central offices. They call them telcos, running power wire and telephone wire inside of there. And anyway, those were left over that was going to be thrown away, and they went in the rack. I actually have a rack too that another company was going to throw away that I got to keep. Let's see. That would go over. I just don't know if that's actually how I want to do it. Even if I get it over, let me just keep looking at it here, and then I'll try and show what I'm talking about. Even if I get it over it, I don't know how well it'll hold it. Oh, that's a lot tighter of a spring than I thought. It's going to mess up my threads. Banging on it like that. Yeah, and you can't have that on the inside. You'll never get the... Okay. But even if I get it in there... Try the biggest one. This one's a bigger diameter. Make sure if it's going to work. Even if I get it in there, which I can probably do by spreading it out some more... Need it on one to do this. I need it on one, not two. I think. I just haven't spread it out enough. Ah. Well, I'm not going to fight him anymore. I just have a feeling. You ever have one of those feelings? Like the best idea is in the back of your mind and you just don't want to do it? Well, that's the one I got. So I'm going to say that welding is the best idea. Cause I can fiddle with that forever just trying to get them in there, and then I don't know if my nuts are going to, you know, all those pieces will actually line up enough to get a good tight grip on it. But the way I had it set. Yeah. I'm going to go. So put them back so that I can see. Oh, I see. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so I can just yeah, and I can just use a little. I think it'll work. Okay. There is one thing I had thought about, and that is that I might have to. Oh yeah. I might have to move one up and down the deal. You know what? I don't know. I mean, I thought about it. Like I was, you know, I was saying, I thought I might have had to put one way up here where that is. If I was going to have to do that, then I wouldn't want it welded. But the door wasn't really working it. It was jerking. It's actually working about as well without the spring as it was with it. But it was jerking really weirdly, even worse when it was on there. So I think it was hooked right there, and I think that was what was causing it. I thought I was fixing it last time, and I was making it worse. I finally realized, you know, well, I knew it. I'm sure I knew it, but somehow I just thought I was fixing it. But, you know, they need even pressure on either side, so I thought this one might have been stretched out. But now that I think about it all more now, I don't think it was. So, let's see what we can do about getting out. Getting out. A welder. I'll just let it go. And I'm doing this stuff here. I guess you need to really see the desk all that much. So, you have trouble getting the freaking trash people to pick up your boxes now? We order a lot of stuff from Wally World. They quit picking up our boxes. It's just the last thing to pick up. I got to talk to some old neighbors and an old neighbor who used to live next door. He said he's beside the recycle bin. We hadn't used it a long, long time because you know, we have such a small amount, and people, and all they're doing is making money off of it, and they want you to jump through hoops to help them make money. You're already paying them. They should. They should not expect you to work for them too, and do all the breaking down and all that. And actually, so I'll move around and around. Isn't that a good idea? Anyway, I figured out that put one in the recycle bug and set the others next to it. That's it. All recycled. But if you put sticks in them, like cut something down or something, then they'll take the one with the sticks in it. I got a restroom screw that's in the way. I'll move things so that I don't knock them over. Thank you. Discovered that this cord has the end, the wires are breaking inside of there. I mean, it's been like that for a long time. But that opens that. Actually, that's going to be close to where I'm going to want. Not sure where I'm going to have to be to do that welding, but sorry, none of this is working so good. Right now, we'll put it over here so I can see where I'm headed. I'll probably do it over there on that old door. Thank you.
us in kind of a fairly precarious position. I think I'll move it again because it's going to fall off. I had it fall the other day, or the other one did. Now I can't see what I'm aiming. There it is. Okay. That's where I'm going.
Thank you.
I had to go get my ruined biscuits that I welded with. Don't mind with your biscuits. Trying to make sure that it's still on and it's aimed in the right place. There's so much light on the screen. Can't even tell. Okay, looks
like it's still on.
Got me a little piece of rebar just to test and make sure it's going to work before I start on that.